and this gentleman to her right also, when I first got to town, this guy was working for another company, giving me some of the best scoop on all the things that's going on in the entertainment industry, as well as popping up in all kind of Instagram posts with different celebrities. And I want to have him on the show today to kind of keep us updated on what's going on in the world of Hollywood. How are you, Disco?
Hey, how you doing, man?
Good to see you, man. Thank you very much for having me.
Yes,
man,
sir.
Appreciate to having you, man, as well. Kind of catch us up on what's going on in there. You said something about, I was hearing about Adrian Broner. What happened with Adrian Broner?
Oh, man. So the homie Adrian Broner, right? Championship boxer right there. Got a chance to catch up with him over there in Florida, in Miami, right? He was at the Super Bowl. He was right there with, who was it? Antonio Brown. Mm-hmm. So, right, they were together.
Oh,
right there.
Adrian Broner and Antonio Brown.
Yeah, together.
Wow, what could go wrong?
And I had caught this exclusive before I catch you up right now, what he just did at the moment. Mm-hmm. He started scolding some young fan who wanted an autograph, and he was like, "You need to be at home asleep." And he was like, "I'm not giving you no picture, I'm not giving you no autograph." So I was like, man, he is a trip. You know what I'm saying?
But I heard he was drunk. Was he drunk?
He's oftentimes drunk, as I was about to get into this story right here. They just caught him drunk last night. Wow. Right there sitting in his Rolls Royce. And he was, you know, breathing. He was conscious, but he was knocked out behind the wheel. Police came up, you know what I'm saying? And they had to shake the car and, like, make a lot of noise to get his attention. He's a little bit out of control. Wow. I'm wishing him the best, man. He's got a lot of talent, but
yeah, he's starting to be known more for off the out of the boxing ring activities opposed to in the ring.
Right. What his antics are, yeah, getting out of control.
Right. What else is going on?
Let's see. This week I got a chance to catch up with the very famous singer Lana Del Rey. Lana Del Rey, and I asked her if she was scared of coronavirus. You know what I'm saying? And she responded yes. Now she canceled her tour also, because she was sick. So some fans are also thinking she might have the coronavirus, you know what I mean? I didn't go as far as to ask her, "Hey, you got the coronavirus, have you been tested?" But I just asked her, "Are you scared of it?" You know what I mean? And she was like, yes.
There's suspicion she may have it.
There's, you know, a couple of people out there, you know, talking. Streets are talking, but we don't know, you know what I'm saying? No confirmations yet. But of course she was supposed to perform at Coachella, one of the biggest concerts around, and that's been postponed. All the way until October. So.
Wow, that's a lot of money being lost. Now, you said there was something about going on with Justin Bieber. What's going on with Justin Bieber?
Justin Bieber, got a chance to catch up with him this week also. I saw him and his wife going to church in Beverly Hills, right? And although he kind of kept it quiet, but a couple of reporters were out there. We were asking some questions, asking him about the coronavirus, because he himself has chose to scale down his tour from stadiums to arenas. So we're going to see what that's going to do. The coronavirus is just hitting home everywhere, of course. We know Tom Hanks and his wife, Rita Wilson, have it. And Justin Bieber just donated, as a matter of fact.
Really?
Towards, yes, coronavirus.
Now, Tom Hanks and his wife, they contracted that in Australia, is that correct?
They did, on the Gold Coast of Australia. Mm-hmm. And there's been some talk to it that he's been giving autographs, and then somebody, one of the fans might have contracted the virus as well from one of the autographs. So this is just a crazy thing. Got the whole world on edge. I can't get no toilet paper. You know what I'm saying? I cannot get no toilet paper. Wow. I did not get any wipes. I got hand sanitizer. I got hand soap to wash my hands. You know, I'm trying to, you know, wash my hands and be very hygienic as much as possible. 20 seconds or more. But this whole thing has just got people in a craze out here. This is crazy.
Well, I saw something online where they said if you can't find any toilet paper, just slice your paper towels in half. That's what I
do. I got some paper towels. I'm stealing napkins wherever I can.
I come on the team for the day, ladies and gentlemen. But now, and last but not least, now they're saying that not only NBA season is going to be suspended, maybe canceled. But what's going on with the Major League?
Major League has been suspended. Soccer has been suspended. Hockey has been suspended. This is crazy. I'm talking about TV show productions. Yesterday, I was going to be a part of another TV show production. Starring Ken Jeong from The Hangover. Oh, he's a very famous dude. That got canceled due to some production. I mean, coronavirus precautions, and this thing is just getting out of control. Riverdale has been suspended production.
Wow.
Coronavirus, this is going crazy. Mm-hmm. I don't know, I'm just going to try to be as hygienic as I can, but I'm going to try not to panic. Mm-hmm. And you know what? I'm going to go get a corona after this. I'm not scared of coronavirus.
You know, it's so funny because it has been reported that corona, the the beer has lost $455 million because of this epidemic. Nobody wants to touch Corona because of that. But people still are getting drunk.
Figure that out.
Well, I appreciate you, Disco, stopping by the show.
Hey, man, it's my pleasure.
Now, where can people want to be able to get more information about your latest updates on celebrity gossip?
Man, please follow all my crazy adventures on Instagram, mostly, primarily. And it's Disco the Don. Just type it in D-I-S-C-O, the T-H-E, D-O-N, Disco the Don. You're going to see all my crazy stories right there. And I really want to thank you for having me. It's been a pleasure.
I appreciate you, my brother.
Yes, sir.
I'm just going to stop by at least once a month to keep us updated on some of the celebrity news, just to be able to keep things intact. But also, ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank you all. I want to thank all my guests for stopping by the show. First and foremost, I want to thank Ty Edwards for stopping by.
Absolutely.
As well as for Wayne Slappy.
Ty.
And Disco
Big stopping Wayne.
By as well. But even more so as well is my special team, my staff, for helping make the Sherrard Show.
That's right.
Really, really
That's
hot
right.
today as well. Mark Walker, my cameraman, as well as a closet Chicago Cubs fan. We can talk about that later. And then as well as my executive producer, being my assistant. And then we also have Paul, our production assistant. We thank you all so much. And then stay tuned for our next episode. We have a very, very special show. You don't want to miss it. Make sure you tune in Saturdays at 4 o'clock, the Sherrard Show. See you next episode.
Yay.